This time we will start our problem with a quarter circle with the radius 20. Then we will pull the line inside this quarter circle from its bottom left corner up until the random point on a vertical radius, as you can see on the sketch. In this way, we have divided our quarter circle into two parts. The bottom part will be triangle with the area of 150 squared units, and inside the upper part, we will inscribe the rectangle in such a way so that its length is located on our constructed line and its height is pulled from the apex of our triangle to the arc of our quarter circle, as you can see on the sketch. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this red rectangle? This problem was sent to me by an email from one of my subscribers, Tanya from Bulgaria. So thank you, Tanya, for this wonderful suggestion. Now, of course, if you guys want to try this problem for your own, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. All right, so let's solve this one. So we're going to start by labeling all the vertices of our triangle as A, B, and C. And we will label the remaining vertices of our rectangle as D, E, and F. Now, let's notice that this is a quarter circle. So this means that our triangle ABC is actually right angle triangle. So we can say that the area of this triangle must be equal to the half of the product of the base and the height. And since we know that the area of this triangle is 150 and the base is 20, we can substitute those values. Now we can simplify a little bit, and we will finally get that the height of this triangle CB must be equal to 15. Next, we know that our triangle is right angle triangle, so we can use the Pythagorean theorem. We can calculate the hypotenuse AB squared as a sum of the leg AC squared and the leg CB squared. We're going to substitute our values, work through this, and we will get that our hypotenuse AB must be equal to 25. All right, now let's pay attention to the radius AC with the length of 20. And let's also notice the line ED. This line actually represents the length of our rectangle, but it also represents the chord of our quarter circle. And we're going to do something really clever here. We're first going to mark the midpoint of the line ED and label it as P. And we can say that the segments PD and EP are both equal to A. Then we will rotate our radius to the point P. In this way, we know that the angle at the point P must be the 90-degree angle. We know this by using a circular theorem, which states that the perpendicular to a chord drawn from the center of a circle bisects the chord. And as you can see, this is exactly our case here, since our radius is pulled from the center of the circle and the point P is midpoint of the line ED. Now we can also label the intersection between our radius and the line FB as Q. Now, because BDEF is a rectangle, this means that the line ED must be parallel to the line FB. So this means that the angle at the point Q must be right angle as well. Now let's notice the segment PD with the length of A. We can slide it down and get that QB must also have the length of A. And let's try to find this length A. We can do this by using our right triangle ABC, and we will call for help the Euclid's theorem of right angle triangle. Now let's isolate our right angle triangle for better understanding. In Euclid's theorem, the leg BC squared must be equal to the product of the segment on the hypotenuse BQ and the hypotenuse AB. So, if we pull the values of BC and BQ from our sketch, And we also know the fact that the hypotenuse AB is 25. We can easily substitute those values and simplify to get that the segment A must have the length of 9. And we can also substitute all the values of A for the value of 9 on our sketch on the left as well. Now, let's stay with the Euclid's theorem for a little longer, and let's try to calculate the height of this triangle QC. We can do this easily with the fact that the square of the height is equal to the product of two segments into which it divides the hypotenuse. So, in our case, QC squared is equal to the product of the segments BQ and QA. Of course, since our hypotenuse has the length of 25 and BQ has the length of 9, this means that QA must have the length of 16. Now we can substitute those values into our equation and simplify to finally get that the height QC must be equal to 12. We can, of course, set this value into our sketch on the left as well. Now, let's notice the line DB and let's label it as X. This line will also represent the height of our rectangle. So we can slide this line downwards and we can conclude that PQ also has the length of X. Now, we can rotate our radius once again, but this time to the point D. Now, let's notice this newly formed right angle triangle BCD. We can, of course, use the Pythagorean theorem and say that the leg BC squared is equal to the hypotenuse CD squared minus the leg BD squared. Now we will substitute our values from the sketch. Then we will expand the left side by using the square of binomial, and we can simplify to get this really nice quadratic equation of x squared plus 24x minus 175 that is equal to 0. Of course, you can use multiple ways to solve this quadratic equation, but in this video I will use the quadratic formula, which states that if we have a quadratic equation in a form of ax squared plus bx plus c that is equal to 0, then we can get the results of x by using the following quadratic formula. Now, of course, from our equation, you can see that the value of a is equal to 1, the b is 24, and c is minus 175. So we're just going to implement those values into our quadratic formula. Now, since a lot of you guys asked me in the comments to do this step by step, I'm going to show you the detailed calculation how to get to the values of x. So first you're going to simplify the things underneath the square root and get 1276. This will simplify to 2 square root of 319. Now we can simplify everything with 2 and get the solution of minus 12 plus minus the square root of 319. Now from this we have two possible solutions. One is that x is minus 12 minus root of 319, and the second one is minus 12 plus root of 319. Of course, we know that the value of x cannot be a negative number, so this means that the only solution for x is minus 12 plus root of 319. And I will rewrite this as square root of 319 minus 12, just for the sake of aesthetics and nothing more. Now we can easily find the area of our rectangle as the product of its length and its height. So since we know that the segments EP and PD are equal to 9, we can conclude that the length must be equal to 18, and we can substitute our values from the sketch. We can then, of course, substitute the value for x, and we will finally get that the area of our red rectangle is equal to 18 times the quantity of square root of 319 minus 12 squared units, and this is our solution. Of course, if this looks ugly to you, you can simplify it if you want to, but I'm going to leave it as it is. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel for more content like this. And if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section. I always love to see when you guys find a different method from mine to solve the problem. And until next time, as always, see you all and take care.